Dearly beloved, in 2015, at the height of the Ebola epidemic, Bill Gates warned the world that the greatest risk of global catastrophe is likely to be a high infectious virus rather than war. To him, the Ebola epidemic was a wake-up call to set the world prepared for the next epidemic. He regretted how we invest huge amounts of money in nuclear deterrent, but have invested little in system stops and epidemic. 5 years after his prediction, COVID-19 is here with us, and sadly, the world is not prepared for it. As of yesterday, 16th March 2020, at 2350 GMT, 162 nations have been affected, with 182,406 confirmed cases and 7,157 deaths. The World Health Organization has declared COVID-19 as a global pandemic as the novel coronavirus continues to rapidly spread worldwide. This coronavirus is claiming lives, threatening the world's economy, barring people from socializing, closing church halls, quarantining nobles, and creating fear and panic among world leaders. But we believe that in times like this, we need not to live in fear and panic or spread anxiety. Christ in you is still the hope of the world. In moments like this, we need to have living faith in the living God. I believe in the God who is alive, a loving and merciful God, my God and your God. I'm convinced that the prayers we have prayed, He has answered, and the roots of the coronavirus is effectively killed. But just as in Mark chapter 11, verse 12 to 21, when Jesus cursed the fig tree, the leaves withered and the roots died the following day. Similarly, I believe by the fervent prayers of the righteous, the roots of the coronavirus is effectively killed. But until the leaves wither and the roots destroyed, it would be wise for us to observe the precautionary measures as given by the World Health Organization and our various leaders in our nations. In my first circular to the church dated 13th March 2020, I brought your attention to some directives from the Executive Council on how we could support government's efforts and to curb the spread of the virus in our nations. However, following the new directives among the press announced by the President of the Republic of Ghana, His Excellency Nana Addo-Dankwa Akufo-Addo, in his address to the nation on Sunday, 15th March 2020, the Executive Council of the Church would like to direct full compliance with these new giving directives from the seat of government on the authority of Scripture as admonished by the Apostle Paul in Romans 13, verse 1. Let every person be subject to the governing authorities, for there is no authority except from God, and those who exist have been instituted by God, unquote. In view of the above, the Executive Council hereby informs the church public in Ghana on the following directives. One, all church services, including retreats, revivals, conferences, funerals, and weddings, be suspended for the next 4 weeks. Two, all Church of Pentecost schools be closed till further notice. Three, The second part of the apostolization program, scheduled for Monday 16th to Sunday 22nd March 2020, has been cancelled. The Royals and Politicians Conference, scheduled for Monday 23rd to Saturday 28th March 2020, has been postponed. A new date will be announced later. The 2020 Easter Convention, which falls within the 4 weeks band announced by the President, has been cancelled. This one is to the Church of Pentecost worldwide. The 2020 General Council meetings, due to the fast rate of infection of the coronavirus in many nations of the world, especially in those considered high-risk zones, and considering that many of our delegates will be coming from over 100 nations, the 2020 Council meetings have been rescheduled as follows. Executive Council meeting, Monday 1st to Saturday 6th June. HES meeting, Monday 8th to Tuesday 9th June. General Council meetings, Wednesday 10th to Saturday 13th June. This is, however, subject to the pandemic situation drastically improving or returning to normalcy, as the situation is being reviewed by the Executive Council on a regular basis. Interim reorganization of church activities. In order to sustain church life through prayer, fellowship, and dissemination of information relative to the pandemic during the interim period, while still maintaining the necessary social distance, the Executive Council further recommends the following. Intensify intercessory prayers at individual and family levels. Take daily personal and family devotion serious. Area heads should arrange and lead ministers and their wives to meet 3 times a week at zonal levels to pray, share fellowship, and send out information as and when necessary. Organize family, friends, and cell meetings in homes and pray and share fellowship. Ensure that our church buildings are opened during the day to give access to individual members who may want to go there to pray and meditate. In all meetings, let us keep the safety and preventive measures announced in the previous circular. Use of electronic and social media. The Pen TV leadership has decided to reorganize the activities and programs on the Pen TV to meet the exigencies of the times. Members are encouraged, therefore, to patronize Pen TV and other social media platforms of the church. Ministers, officers, and the entire membership are encouraged to use the social media and other electronic means to reach out to one another. Where possible, such programs should run online. In addition, the use of radio and other information centers should be intensified. Observing the Lord's Day, that is Sunday, Hebrews 10:24 to 25 reads, and I quote, "And let us consider how to stir up one another to love, good works, not neglecting meeting together, as is the habit of some, but encouraging one another, and all the more as we see the day of the Lord drawing near." Unquote. As exhorted by the above scripture, we should find ways of spurring one another on in times like these. None of us should consider these times as a period to be lax in Christian convictions and devotions. Not at all. Rather, we should be encouraged by the scriptural admonition to, among other things, joyfully observe the Lord's Day, that is Sundays, in a meaningful and spiritual devotions among families, friends, neighbors, in small numbers, and when practicable, at cell centers. Fastings and prayer. In the next 4 weeks, every Friday shall be dedicated for fasting and praying for the nations and the world. For the nation and the world against the pandemic at the individual levels. All ministers, officers, and members must take note of the above and comply accordingly. I know that the God of the Church of Pentecost is still with us. He rules, and I know that through our prayer, he will cause this epidemic that has become a pandemic to be effectively erased from the planet Earth in no time. May the good Lord, the one you serve, our God and your God, be with you now and forevermore. God bless us all.